So what you get in the box here is you get one leg. You have to buy them separately. And you get one leg, and I don't know why they did that, because the control box, which you also buy separately, only has two outputs. So really, why Taro decided to split these up, I guess their thought was it would be easier to buy spares. Not sure. But you'll want to buy two of these, okay? And you're going to want one of these control boxes. And the control box just comes like this, and it's got a power lead on it, and a 4-pin a mystery connector that I haven't found any purpose for, a servo input that accepts PWM, so that's kind of come from your receiver, and then only two outputs for the motors. And the landing gear kit itself comes with the mechanism, and it's already assembled like this. It comes with a spare for the leg, and this part here, as you can imagine, goes like that. Some hardware, fasteners. It comes with a 25 millimeter boom clamp, which is probably for mounting on certain taro frames. So this is, you know, made for taro, but I'm going to adapt it to something else. And there's a couple of these silicone bits that would go on the on here and provide a little bit of a, you know, a finish there, and they're color coded, which is, you know, good and bad, depends how you really want it to look. But you get a red one and a black one, so you're kind of stuck with it. And like I said, a spare one of these, which is a nice touch. The box is pretty minimal, and it has some nice diagrams on it. I really like that they took the time to put this information, because I was able to check on the website and decide, yeah, this is going to fit on my unit before I ordered. And it's really always nice when they provide good information. And in the box as well, there is a manual, sort of IKEA style diagrams with a bit of kanji and a bit of, I'm assuming that's kanji, what do I know? A bit of kanji and a bit of English, and some clear diagrams about how to assemble it in different scenarios on the taro stuff. And yeah, good job. What isn't provided is any documentation on this little sucker. However, if you go on the web and read in the product descriptions, there's a blurb provided, and it says a few things. The working voltage for this is 10 volts to 26 volts, or 3S to 6S range. It has reverse power protection. It tells you that there's a receiver connection here, which is kind of obvious. One thing that's not obvious is the polarity of that connector. It doesn't really say, although there's that little notch. And if you know that you've got a cable that's polarized right, which all you need to know is ground is towards the middle. You can use any, you know, even the non-standard, the non-notched kind. And it'll work fine, but it's kind of lame that they didn't label that in any way, and it's not written in the documentation either, what little there is. There is power protection on this. What that means, I think what they're intending to mean is that it won't just raise the gear regardless of the switch position as soon as you give it power. You've got to cycle the switch first, which I'll show when I demo it. There's a nice indicator light on here, which you'll never see when it's actually installed, but it does tell you what it's doing. And there's a fail-safe mode, which I'll demonstrate in a second. And one of the things about the fail-safe is if you remove the signal, it'll go in a fail-safe. And then they give you like four lines of troubleshooting, which I'm just going to spell out for you in the video. So really my aim is to convey this for you in a video.